with them only. I think Václav Havel certainly would be supporting people, European Ukrainians, as you have nicely described them. But at the same time, I think that he would be trying to support some steps that really can be suggested now. The first thing I am 100% convinced is the unity of Europeans. That's the biggest concern, and I think Václav Havel had some power to bring Europeans together in his own way. I certainly would be last to overestimate the impact of the Czech Republic, but the Czech Republic represented by Havel or Havel's ideas has had a certain impact. Then Václav Havel certainly would be stressing transatlantic relationship. He would be communicating with not only with his dearest friend Madeleine Albright, but with whole spectrum of Americans. What I'm saying is another interesting power of Václav Havel was to help Americans to reach consensus where sometimes they've been fighting and fighting in the past years. The resolution that enabled the yesterday's ceremony speaks for itself. It was signed by Eric Cantor and Nancy Pelosi jointly together. So I think Václav Havel would certainly try to translate his deep commitment in human rights, support for Ukrainian civil society, at least to some actions that can be helpful and can lead to, you know, it seems to me that Europe and United States are not living now to the challenge of the history. This is a historical challenge, this strange twist of Vladimir Putin to become almost like a tsar, first Russian tsar of the 21st century, with all the rhetorics and with all his pathos and the ability to mobilize the Russian society for his cause. I think that this needs a strong, philosophically grounded and spiritual answer, not just, I would say, it's not only a matter for technocrats, it's a matter for philosophers, and that's, I think, would be the Havelian response to the situation.